Good morning. Good to see everybody here today. Excuse me. I'm sorry. All right. Welcome. We're going to have our annual Christmas play a little bit later on the service, but we're going to enjoy some great singing together of the hymns. And Don, can you turn me down just one little notch? There you go. We're going to do some great hymn singing in a minute, and there'll be special music during the play too. But we're so glad that you're here. Want to invite you all to come back tonight at 5 o'clock. It's our annual Christmas dinner. We'd love to have you. We're going to have plenty of food. We'll have turkey and ham and dressing, and we'll just have a great, great time together. So please come and join us for that. Bring your friends and neighbors. We'll have a good, good time together. In your bulletin here today, if you notice, there's a little tear-out portion. If you have any prayer requests, or if there's any way our church can be of help to you, if you'd like more information, just fill it out and drop it in the offering plates that are at the doors. But we're so glad to have you here. Just a word of thank you. We took the Christmas gifts down for our Christmas family this Friday to the Sunshine Center in Montgomery, and they were overwhelmed. And we appreciate your generosity. You made a great difference in that family's life, and they're going to have a joyous Christmas. So we thank everybody for participating. It was a great, great thing. Thank you so much. And let's see, just a couple of things just let you know coming up on the 21st of December. We're going to have our candlelight and carol, have a little bit different since Christmas so late in the week this year. So we're going to have it on Wednesday night at 6 o'clock. So if you'd like to join us for that, and Clarence will be here to sing. I think Buddy's going to sing for us too. And Dan may just break out in song. And there he is. Good to see Dan with us here today. But that's always a great time together, so please come and join us. Great way to get ready for the Christmas season. All right. Want to share just a few prayer requests. And the poinsettias will be here next Sunday. So thank you for those donating in memory and honor. If your name's not in here, it just means you got in here after the bulletin was printed. Some of our prayer requests, continue to remember Ina Thornton in your prayer. She's still in the hospital, and it's great to see Dan here. He's nursing Susan back to health. Soon she'll be back, so keep praying for Susan as she recovers, and remember Marilyn and her daughter Danielle, and remember Gary and Bonnie also in our prayers, and Jim and Barbara. Keep them in our prayers also, too, and I'm sure I'm missing somebody else. But we got a lot of folks that we want to lift up in the Lord. But it's good to see each and every one of you here today. We're going to have a word of prayer, and then we'll begin our time of some good singing, and then we'll have our Christmas play. And we're glad you're here for that, for the exciting Blue Ridge Players. They came from miles and miles to participate in this. So, all right, let's have a word of prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you for your love and your kindness. We thank you for the chance to gather in your name and to sing praises to your name. And remember this Christmas season, your gift of your Son that you sent so that we could know your love and grace and so that he could bring us forgiveness and salvation. And we ask you to bless everyone that's here today, Lord. Help them to feel your presence and encouragement. Speak to their hearts. And we lift up those again we mentioned. We ask you to be with Miss Ina, comfort her heart and help her to heal. And we ask you to be with Marilyn, her daughter. We thank you that Susan's doing well. We just ask you to bless Jim and Barbara. And we ask you to lift up the many others that are upon your hearts, Gary and Bonnie and the many others. And just bless us today. We thank you for your love. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. All right, grab your hymnals and order of worship, hymn number 95, Go Tell It on the Mountain.
Yummy stand.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere.
Mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching, o'er silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain. glory. Down in a lowly manger, the humble Christ was born. And God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. All right, our next hymn is 346. He has the whole world in his hands. 346. And we're going to sing it three times, number one, three, and four. James.
He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole his hands. Verse 3. He's got the little tiny baby in his hands. He's got the little tiny baby in his hands. He's got the little tiny baby in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
And I'm sorry, I forgot this is the fellowship song. So now we're going to fellowship and we'll come back and we'll sing verse 4. So y'all greet each other. We're so glad you're here this morning.
Thank you.
right, our next song is our offertory hymn, number 253. It's okay, I know. It's number 253, the doxology, number 253.
Now at this time, Dave Brown will come and lead us in dedication for our offering at this time. And just to give you a heads up, Dave is in costume. So that's right.
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this opportunity for us to come together during this season. And we pray that you heal those that couldn't be with us today. And pray that for she recovers. Dear Lord, we pray that you receive these offerings and use them for this church's purpose. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. So last week I got to sing my favorite song for you, Christmas song. This week I get to sing my second favorite Christmas song. And a lot of you ladies said that it was your favorite Christmas song. So here we go.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know the blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Oh, Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? That sleeping child you're holding is a great I am. Mary, did you know?
Thank you, Miss Emily, and thank you, Linda, too, very much. All right, we're going to present our annual Christmas play and with the Blue Ridge Players today. And the title of this year's play is Getting Joe in the Christmas Spirit. And give us just 1 minute. All right. I guess I'll sit here. Okay. Great. Joe has lost his spirit, Christmas spirit. He sits alone in his easy chair in front of the television, eating his Christmas Eve dinner of cold pizza. He wants nothing of Christmas specials or old sentimental movies. So he puts on the news and begins to doze off and dream. And now for the news. Today, Congress has begun implementation of their new bill, which will hire 87,000 new IRS agents. Everybody get ready to be audited.
Y'all go ahead. And that's why I'm in a bad mood. There's never any good news.
You are wrong, Joe.
Who are you and what are you doing in my house?
I'm Gabriel, full-time angel and part-time power forward for the Edgewood Academy basketball team. This is my second job.
Son, my name is John. I'm a full-time angel, part-time actor, and I'm the state champion for the Otumka High School drama team.
This makes no sense.
It's not our fault. You're dreaming. God sent us here to cheer you up.
Let's hurry this up. I've got play practice in an hour, and I'm going to be a wise man. And I still got to get makeup on.
Wait. I'm in a bad mood because there's nothing good happening. Do you hear the news? 87,000 IRS agents. Sounds like bad news to me.
Haven't you ever read Romans 8:28? And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose.
But taxes are evil.
But God is good. Check out the TV.
The picture shows a palace covered in gold and silver. Caesar Augustus walks in.
I have gold and I have silver. What else could I want? Oh, I know. I need more. But how can I get more? How about, I know, I'll issue a census, and I'll get everyone back to their hometown. That way I'll have a record of everybody, and I can tax everybody. Huh. You know, I saw a buddy raking his leaves the other day. I could tax leaves. That's it. That's what I'll do. What else could I tax? I'm a genius.
See what I mean? What good could come of this?
God can. Mary and Joseph lived where? Nazareth. Where was Jesus, the Messiah, born?
Micah 5:2 says the Messiah, God's son, was to be born in Bethlehem.
Joe, you were wrong. Good does happen every day, and the greatest good that could ever happen was when God sent a son.
Yeah, but mean old Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken, and everyone went to his hometown to register.
Remember Genesis 50:20? You intended to harm me, but God intended it for good.
Joe, you were wrong. Good does happen every day, and the greatest good that could ever happen was when God sent a son.
Joe turns back to the TV. Mike Lindell here. Thank you for supporting me in these troubling times. Today we have a one-time only sale on my pillows. 50% off of our king and queen sizes. Just type in the promo code Don Jones is Grumpy and be ready for the best sleep of your life.
I need one of those pillows.
Me too. It's on my wish list.
You know who needed one of those pillows? Jesus did, because there was no room for him in the inn. You know, nobody has room for God these days in their lives. It's hopeless.
I think you're wrong, Joe. Check out the TV.
The screen shows the small village of Bethlehem and zooms in on a small inn. The camera leads you through the door, and we find a young innkeeper working hard on her computer.
I bet you didn't know we had computers. Long before the Apple, there was the Olive. It was pretty good, but it broke down a lot. You're talking about Mary and Joseph, aren't you? I remember them well. And you know, we get a bad rap when it comes to that precious couple. But the night they came in, it was madness. People were flooding the streets. Everyone was overbooked. And we simply had no room for them. But I was able to offer them our one-of-a-kind open-air concept room. But seriously, I could have shoved them in a room with a stranger inside the inn. But they needed privacy. And as it turns out, that stall provided a warm cave for them to welcome their bundle of joy. And you know, I think most people probably did not care to make the time for them, but we sensed, even though we didn't understand it, we sensed that something special was going to take place. that a miracle was going to take place, and we needed a miracle. Well, it appears that I have some fussy guests in the penthouse suite. Bye.
See, Joe, not everybody's heart is closed to the Lord.
Look, another commercial. Did I ever tell you I love commercials?
It's one of those relief commercials.
Isn't there something wrong for government?
You're the strangest angels ever.
Is your back hurting? Are you having trouble getting Pat Boone off your tennis court? Then you need to order a month's supply of Relief Factor. With Relief Factor, you will live life pain-free.
I wish I could live life pain-free. I just don't think we have much hope. What good news do I have to get through today?
I think hope just came on the TV.
Through the dark of night, you can see shepherds huddled by a fire. And then suddenly, a host of angels appear encompassed in bright light.
We have come from afar to proclaim the good news. We are God's angelic choir.
You all weren't acting so angelic last night.
Hi, Daddy.
We can sing of the good news better than we can tell of it. Okay, away in the manger.
Down where he lay, the
commercial?
I love commercials, but how many are they going to show in a row?
Applebee's means good food for good people. Aren't you hungry? It's time to get your Bourbon Street steak and the Oreo shake with a cherry on top. We'll be eating good in the neighborhood.
My girl is banging. You all just calm down. Nobody be getting excited. Nothing's gonna happen. Nothing good, that is. Nothing ever has good happens. And no one's gonna respond to a Christmas message.
Wrong you are, old Joe sitter on the couch. John, would you hold my rake for me? I heard that Caesar was looking to tax me. Joe, you are wrong, 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 and wrong some more. People respond to the message of Christmas even when it isn't Christmas. Take me, for example. We were just studying the stars, and then God got hold of our hearts. Could a Messiah really be on the way? So we wanted to believe. We dropped everything and headed to Jerusalem. When we saw the star, we were filled with joy, and we headed to Bethlehem, and we bowed down and worshiped him. We also gave him all the gifts we had, but more than that, we gave him our devotion. There was a man named Joseph who doubted too. God sent him an angel to tell him that Jesus was coming and that he would be the Savior of the world. God's message was enough for him. He spent the rest of his life loving and serving the Lord. What about you?
You know, I do believe. I believe that God sent us good news, and even though everybody wasn't ready for it, he still came. I believe God brings hope, and whenever anybody sees the stars, their hearts long to worship the Savior. I want to be that star, and I think I'm going to be the Christmas morning service at Blue Ridge. Merry Christmas, everybody.
All right. Y'all come on up. Y'all come on up.
One, two, three.
One.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Christ is born.
All right. All right. All right, we appreciate our great actors, and they did a good job, and they always do. All right. All right. I don't know about you, but I love Christmas stories, especially when they're real stories. And I read a story the other day about a family in Chicago. You hear a lot of bad news in Chicago, and there was a family going through bad news. They had been burned out. The little apartment that they lived in had been burned to the ground, and they lost everything they had, absolutely everything. Their name was Delgados. Their family consisted of 60-year-old grandmother Perfecta. That's an interesting name, but Perfecta Delgado, and she was raising her two little granddaughters, Lydia and Jenny. And they lost absolutely everything. And it's hard to imagine losing everything, and even when you don't have much. But I remember there was for the Chicago Sun-Times, there was a person who'd heard about that story. And so he decided to go and to visit them to kind of do a personal interest story. When he got there and he visited their home, two things he noticed. One was that when he walked in the room, how stark things were. They had nothing. They had a table and a couple chairs, no furniture. I guess they had some beds, but that was it. And on the table was about a pound of rice. That was the only food they had in the house. He noticed that, but he also noticed something else. He noticed that they had hope. And they had encouragement, and they had joy, even though they didn't have anything. And in fact, they had so little, they got out of the apartment where they were living simply with the clothes on their back. And in fact, the two little girls, and when they went to school, They had the one little dress they got out of the apartment, and they also had one thin sweater between the two of them. And when they would walk to school, what they would do is they knew the halfway point, and so one little girl would wear the sweater halfway there, and then they would swap it. So they'd only be freezing half the way to school. But as he walked out of that apartment, and he wrote his little story about them and all they'd lost, he noticed that they still had hope, and they had encouragement. And it was something he couldn't quite understand. Well, anyway, he wrote the story, told what had happened, just like when the tornado came, it helped a lot of people lost things. And so he wondered what had happened to them. And it was Christmas Eve, and there was nothing going on very exciting in the city. And so he decided to take one of the cars from the Sun Times and go down and visit this family. If there were any breaking stories, they could reach him. And when he got there, he was amazed. He was amazed because people had heard their story and they were filled with tremendous generosity. And in fact, they had filled up the house. When he opened up the door, the first thing he saw was a tree that was huge and covered in lights and ornaments, and it was filled to the brim underneath. The little table that they had before that only had 1 pound of rice on it now was completely covered in all kinds of canned food. Not only that, people had sent them plates and dishes and all the things you need to cook with. And not only that, the little girls who only had one sweater to share now each had been given 8 heavy winter jackets. There were also gifts for her, and in addition to that, thousands of dollars had been donated to them. Now, as he looked around that, he said, if I had all that, I'd be hoarding every bit of it. Glad I had it, but being hoarding it. And he says, when I came in, I was surprised by 2 things. One is what they were doing. You know what they were doing? They were packing up a lot of it. What were they going to do? They were going to give it away. The excess food, the excess clothes, and yes, even money. They'd never had anything, but they had everything now. And they knew of friends and neighbors that were doing without, and so they didn't feel like they could be in so much abundance and not let somebody they knew do without. And so as they packed up in boxes, preparing to go back to their old neighborhood and to share what they had with those in need, they talked with a reporter. And the reporter shared a simple thing. He looked over everything that he had, and he said, look at all this. This must be the most wonderful Christmas gift that you've ever received. And this was her response. He said, this is wonderful. This is very good. She gestured toward the largesse, all the gifts and that had been given. He said, we did nothing to deserve this. It's a gift from God. But she added, it's not the greatest gift. No, we celebrate that tomorrow. That is Jesus. To her, this child in a manger was the undeserved gift that meant everything. More than material possessions, more than comfort, more than security. And that moment, something inside of me wanted desperately to know this Jesus. Because in a sense, I saw him in Perfecta and in her granddaughters. They had peace despite poverty, while I had anxiety despite plenty. They knew the joy of generosity, while I only knew the loneliness of ambition. They looked at heavenward for hope, while I only looked out for myself. They experienced the wonder of the spiritual, while I was shackled to the shallowness of the material. And something made me long for what they had, or more accurately, for the one they knew. Now, I wish I could say after that moment he got on his knees and he accepted Jesus, but he didn't. But it planted a seed in his heart. And then somebody got his wife, and she became a Christian. And then he began to explore the Christian faith, and in time he gave his life to Christ. But he never forgot that story, because that's what Christmas is. Christmas is the greatest gift for you and me. Our little angels up here came and sang. And when the angels did come, what did they do? It says, and there were shepherds lying out in their fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Our world doesn't know they need to be saved, but they do. They need a Redeemer and they need hope. And the hope they find is in the little baby born in a manger. And we need to share that message. And just like Perfecta and the Delgados lived out their faith and planted seeds through how they lived the Christmas season, that's what God calls us to do. In fact, when you walk around this time of year, you find people really in three conditions. One, like the Perfecta and her family, you find people who know the joy of Jesus and they share it. They share it in their smile, in their heart, and in what they share. They want to invite people to the Christ child. You'll also find people that don't even know they need a Savior. They don't even understand what they're missing out on. They desperately need it, but they don't know how to receive it. And then third, we have a whole third group of people, and you know who they are? They're people who've been saved, they know the Lord, but somehow they forget the lostness they experienced. They forget what it was like to be without Jesus. They forget what it's like to be without hope. And they just kind of think everything rumbles along, but it doesn't. They take for granted the Christmas season. We need to be like the Delgados. We need to praise Jesus in the good and the bad, and we need to thank Him for His most precious gift. And we need to share that with everyone we meet. Where is your heart this Christmas season? We hope that just like Joe, you'll get the Christmas spirit, and you will share the good news, and you'll rejoice in Jesus. But more than that, like the angels, like the shepherd, like the wise men, we will worship our Savior, and we will proclaim the good news. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank You for the message of Christmas because it's meant for each and every one of us. There's not a person here, there's not a person we meet, Lord, that we know that You didn't come for. You came for us. You came to redeem us. You came to give us hope. You came to love us. And Lord, everyone we meet needs to know that story because that story is for them. And Lord, I just ask You to regenerize our hearts. And help us just to feel the joy and the wonder of this season. But more than that, let us share the hope that we find. We love You, Lord, and we praise You because You loved us first. In Christ's precious name we pray. Amen. We're going to have a brief time of invitation. If you need prayers today, you need someone to pray for you, I'll be here at the front. If you've never received that Christmas gift, you can today be proud to lead you in a prayer of faith to Jesus. If there's someone you need to pray for today, and to lift them up to the Lord, then this is the time to do it. Let us stand and sing as Emily leads us in our hymn of invitation.
Number 407, Because He Lives, 407.
Jesus, He came to love, heal and forgive. He bled and died
to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because He lives, I can face to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy He gives, but greater still, the calm assurance this child can face certain days because He lives. Because He lives.
to our players again. They did a good job, didn't they? All right. Appreciate everybody. All right. You did good. All right. We think there's some Oscar-winning performances in there somewhere. All right. We invite you two things. I forgot one thing. 5 o'clock tonight is our Christmas dinner. We'd love to have you come and join us. We got tons of food starting already to come in. So turkey and ham and dressing and all kinds of things. And, oh, and then also this Wednesday, we're going Christmas caroling. And so if you know of anybody that needs to be caroled to, we want to go by and do that. The only thing I'll say, I didn't say, Jackie, if the weather's looking really bad, we might try Tuesday. So, because we don't want to stand out in the rain. So anyway, but we'll make it happen one day or another. And all right. Glad to have each of you here with us. We'll sing our closing chorus.
I'm sorry, 384.
All right.
The Bond of Love, 384.
Take it
all.
Okay.
We are one in the bond of love. We are one in the bond of love. We have joined our spirit with the Spirit of God. We are one in the bond of love.
Amen. Y'all be a blessing as you go out this week.